Hi everybody, this is Stu with Main Street Mower, and today we're talking about a classic battle, the STIHL MS-194T. Versus the STIHL MS-201TC, and even though it's not on here, dash M. These are both professional arborist climbing saws, and we have their sprocket covers off so you can see in and see the guts. This saw is made in Virginia, as you can tell by its serial number that starts in a 5. It is made out of an all-plastic body. It has 31.8 cc's, and it puts out 1.88 horsepower. That is part of its modeling going from the 193 to the 194. They redesigned the top end of the cylinder and they upped the horsepower from 1.7 all the way up to 1.88. So it's a noticeable jump in power. Compare that to the 201TC, and you can't see it on the badge, but there's a dash and then an M that stands for m-tronic, which is referencing the computer control that's on the carburetor of this saw here. This saw is a 35.2 cc engine that puts out a smashing 2.41 horsepower. As I said, this one is made in Virginia. This one is made in Germany. That's important because STIHL kind of reserves, for the sake of quality control, some of their higher end products. Some of their more expensive products are still made in Germany, whereas Virginia manufactures a bulk of their equipment. When you get into the guts of this saw, you can just see that the craftsmanship, the tolerances, everything is a little bit better than this saw here. So let's look at the MS-194 inside. This saw is built more like a homeowner saw than a commercial saw. You know, all of STIHL's homeowner and mid-range lines chainsaws, they all have poly bodies. This muffler is something that we see burn out and fall off in a couple years' time. You also notice that the chain catch, this is where your chain flops over if it becomes derailed, it's plastic and it's made into this cover. So if this is damaged and broken, you have to replace this whole piece here. Your dogs, your bumper spikes here are plastic. Now on the 201, you have a much better muffler. Honestly, we don't ever sell this muffler. It's treated anodized metal that is very durable, holds up a long time. The muffler actually extends up underneath the saw here. You can see that instead of plastic, the body of this saw is all made out of metal. You can see that nice machining going on there. You have a replaceable metal bumper chain catch here at the bottom, and then you have your metal bumper spikes, your dogs up front. This saw also has winter and summer mode. We're here in Florida, so we never touch this switch.
Caught on camera in Florida, that was a man in swim trunks who appeared to fall out of the sky and onto a parked car at a dealership. Amazingly, he was just able to get up and walk away.
But the rest of the country, if you get below 50 degrees, you push this switch up and it diverts airflow from around the engine so that warm air is coming in through the carburetor, preventing icing inside the carburetor itself. This one, you also have oil control, so you have an oil setting here for how much bar oil you're pumping out into your chain. Whereas this one, the oil's preset, you cannot change it. Another little feature on the 201 is that you have STIHL's trademarked ElastoStart handle. So there's a spring in the handle here that saves your fingers in the case of snapback. M-tronic is a computer controlled carburetor that takes the risk of flooding out of the equation. It makes the saw run optimally in all conditions. Changes in temperature as your air filter gets dirty, M-tronic system's gonna compensate for that. To get this saw into a cranking position, all you have to do is squeeze the trigger, bring this arm up, and let go of the trigger while you're holding this top arm up. And it's gonna sit in this position with a little triangle setting. You'll no longer see the carburetor throttle and choke butterflies that this saw here has. And you can put this saw in this position, hot or cold. It will never flood, you just pull it in that position until it cranks. Cranking this saw involves locking the throttle, so it's holding your throttle down for you, setting it to choke here, and priming this primer bulb here. Then you would pull it twice, you'd hear it pop, you'd take it off choke, and you'd pull it till it cranks, and then you would take it out of position there. Now, price tag. This one is $389. Very economical, very durable saw. Almost every landscaper we know runs this saw and runs it for years without any problems. But every professional tree service climber, this is their coveted saw. So $389 here. This one is currently $729. We're shooting this video in 2021, and steel pricing has not changed in about 20 years. These saws have just had a price jump this year from $349 and $699. So they're both up $30 right now. The stock bar and chain that come on these, on either saw, you're capable of running 6 bars and chains. You can run a 12, 14, or 16 narrow, or you can also run a 12, 14, or 16 wide. It is recommended by STIHL on this saw with the lower horsepower that you run the narrow chain because it's not as much tooth to drag through the wood. On this, they recommend the thicker 50 gauge chain, and the stock bar and chain that would come with these is this bar along with this chain. Now, one thing about this chain characteristic here, the PMM3, is that it only comes as a safety chain and it will not cut on the nose. So if the plan is to have your landscape crew outfitted with a saw that they can do palms with, this is a beautiful and safe combination. If you're an arborist and you're gonna be making more complicated cuts while up in the tree, this is the 50 gauge bar. This is the chain that comes with this saw. This is a PS chain, so it's a new Pico Super 3. It has the ability to do a plunge cut, and it has a higher cutting performance than this chain here, and also has a 15% longer life. And you can get this in a few other, you can get this in a yellow label chain as well. Both of these saws have a place to port in. In our shop, we have an analyzer from STIHL called the MGD1. On this saw, you have a port here now where we can plug in and we can read hours and start attempted cranks on this saw. And we can also leave notes on this saw. On the 201 TCM, this is your port in here. And when you plug in, you're able to reset the carburetor along with all of these features as well. The warranty on these saws, no matter if it's this one or this one, the warranty is 90 days. Whereas on other saws, it's a 1 year or a 2 year. And part of the reason STIHL does that is that they do not want a homeowner to own this saw because it is more dangerous than a two-handed ground saw that you operate from the waist. This is something that you have a hoop for your lanyard. You're gonna be on a ladder or in a tree holding a spinning chainsaw with one hand that could slingshot towards you. And STIHL only wants a trained professional to do that type of thing. To discourage homeowners from buying these, because homeowners want these saws. They are a cool all-around saw. You can use them on the ground or in the tree, but they are more dangerous. They only give you a 90-day warranty, and they don't care who you are, if you're homeowner, if you're commercial. If you do the six-pack of STIHL Ultra Oil, doesn't matter, 90 days is all you get. And that is actually the warranty on the battery climbing saw as well. So to sum this up, the 194 versus the 201, both great saws, both last a long time, both perform really well, but they are made for two different customers. This is made for a landscaper who is doing light tree work. This is made for a professional tree service company. So I am going to put a bar and chain on these so you can see the scabbard. This has a much nicer scabbard than this one. So if you want to watch how to put a bar and chain on your saw, we have a link to that video right there. Check it out. See, this cover actually has a hook that goes in here and it has a hoop here. I guess this would be to tie a rope and hoist this up into the tree. I don't know if I'd trust my saw hanging by this little hook here, but it's still a really cool scabbard. So this saw comes with this scabbard here. Well, that's our comparison video of the MS-194T versus the MS-201-TCM. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, and we'll keep putting out cool new videos for you to watch. If you have any other videos like this you want to see, drop them in the comments below. Thank you very much.